only freshmen are allowed on campus, so in a way, it forces you to make friends with the people in your class, but especially the ones on your floor. I made friends with the girls on my floor, and it was good for a solid week. And then the group started splitting, and I was not interested in doing the things that they thought were okay. Once they started stealing and cheating, I removed myself from the situation. My roommate flat out told me one day that she switched her test with her friend that sat next to her in anatomy because she wasn't good in anatomy. They're both nursing majors, and I don't know about you, but I don't really want a nurse taking care of me that I cheated her freshman year. Also, when I learned that they stole, I asked this girl if she, why she had, her ice cream looked good because it's ice cream and in college. And she goes, well, I stole it, and I honestly don't feel that bad about it. That was the moment that when I learned that I should lock my stuff in my room, and that a lot of people aren't what they seem to be. Granted, I should have tried to make friends with my roommate a little better because currently we don't get along, but I felt as though there was no point since she's leaving next semester. Turns out not being the case, just to say. When people say that joining clubs and groups was the best part of college for them, they're not lying. I was in Starbucks one morning standing in line, and a random guy came up to me and started talking to me. He asked about high school, and I told him the best parts of high school were whenever I was able to sing. I wrote in my senior speech last year that I was going to email Mr. Durstein to vent about the choir director. Well, there's no need for that because there isn't a choir at LaSalle. There isn't even a music program. Anyway, I was talking to this guy and slowly realized that it had been a solid 2 weeks and I hadn't sung or played the piano. And if you know me, I do that every single day. He told me that there's this thing called The Mask, which is the musical at LaSalle, and that auditions were that night. I ended up doing my homework and debated on auditioning or not, and my friend said, you know, just do it. What harm can you do? So I put on my big girl pants, printed out my audition piece, and went to audition. I got a call back and was the only freshman in the musical this year. If that isn't a confidence booster, I don't know what would be. I went throughout the semester spending every night, from 6 p.m. to 10 p.m., sometimes midnight, at rehearsal. And that's a big change going from high school. We had 6 performances, and it was a great feeling being back on stage, but it was weird not being with the people I'm used to. Last month, we had another audition for something called Mavericks, which is 6 short shows directed by students, and I got the lead of one of them. Those will be showing in February, so if you're near Philadelphia, which we are, you should come see them. I also auditioned for improv, which I got on the improv team, which was unexpected because I didn't even know what improv was, and I just kind of went in. Anyway, the point of me talking about The Mask is because it saved me in a way. Nobody but I can tell you this, but the first semester of freshman year is really hard. And you think that the friends you make your first semester of freshman year, are going to be your friends for the rest of your college career. That's not the case at all. And everyone in college, upperclassmen, will tell you that the friends you make your first semester will not be your permanent friends. But once you join a club or a group, you can make friends. And at LaSalle, theater is a club that's being cool because we're a D1 school, but no one really cares because it's musical. You can sing and dance, but you can play sports. Anyway, this is where I was able to make my 2 best friends. We have constant sleepovers, stay up late studying, and go out to some shindigs together. The people at DOP are definitely different from the ones that I meet at LaSalle. The people here are nice and strive to be good people, and I witnessed the harsh reality that is life when I realized that people everywhere aren't as nice as they are in DOC. Everyone thought I was so nice and caring, which is great, yet that can be an issue when they start taking advantage of you. Do you remember, okay, freshmen will remember because it's kind of easy to, the transition from middle school to high school? And the teachers at DOC, they guided you and they helped you write papers and with time management. That's what I expected to happen coming to college. That was not the case, don't expect that. I went to school and was surprised that college was so easy for the first week. Then I got a run for my money and was assigned a final my first week of college. something is assigned 3 months in advance, you have to start. And when you're bored and have nothing else to watch on Netflix, you start a little bit at a time, because by the end of the semester, you'll get overwhelmed because finals week is filled with assignment after assignment. My history class, I had to write a 10-page paper comparing Lincoln's wife and the guy who found in Georgia. And then it was due the same day. I had a 2-hour exam. So finals are 2 hours long. That was a shocker. Anyway, I would also like to say that when you're going to choose a college, seniors aren't here, but so the juniors, you can do it in many ways. I basically applied to 14 and got accepted to 13 because Vanderbilt has an 8% acceptance rate. And I ended up debating my financial options. I went with LaSalle because I decided to go somewhere I'm not 100% in love with, but it has a 5-year master's program, and I won't be in debt once I leave. I'm going through this year and seeing how it goes. I got a call from Bethel last week to sing in their choir, so that's always a backup plan. But just know that just because you make a decision on a college, that doesn't mean you're stuck there. So currently, I'm going to enter my second semester of college. I'm double majoring in speech pathology and Spanish. And honestly, I'm just going to go with the flow and see how it goes. So the epiphany I got from college was that a lot of the time, people aren't what you think they are. I had a few friends already that fell through because of my busy schedule. But it's okay, because by waiting and looking for friends, I made two that will be there with me no matter what. Plus, I know that I can always see Morgan Levy and Sarah Mattis whenever I want, because FaceTime is a thing. Now it's winter break, and I'm going to Western Pennsylvania to visit one of my friends from college who lives in Johnstown. And if you know anything about Johnstown, we're going to the Flood Museum. I took her to the Mennonite Heritage Center, so it was an equal trade. After finishing my first semester of college, I know that there is still a whole lot for me to learn, but so far, I have learned that I can walk around campus dreading on the fact that my classes are really hard and I can't play the piano every day. But instead, I think about what good came from